The next question says a crystal has a coefficient of expansion 13 into 10 raised to minus 7 per degree Celsius in one direction and 231 into 10 raised to minus 7 per degree Celsius in every direction at right angles to it. Then the cubical coefficient of expansion is. Now here we need to understand that generally alpha for a cube also have the same value in all the dimensions because the dimension expands uniformly. This kind of expansion is called as isotropic expansion, where alpha for x, alpha for y and alpha for z would be same. But in this case, the alpha is given different for different dimensions. For example, if we assume alpha x to be of 13 into 10 raised to minus 7 per degree Celsius, then alpha y and z, which are both perpendicular to x, is given as 231 into 10 raised to minus 7 per degree Celsius. Now, since we know gamma is 3 alpha, it's actually delivered from a general formula as alpha 1 plus alpha 2 plus alpha 3, which is actually alpha x plus alpha y plus alpha z. If the expansion in all the three dimensions is same, it becomes 3 alpha. And that's why this formula is applicable for isotropic expansion. But for anisotropic, this is the formula we need to use. Remember, isotropic expansion means expansion uniformly in all the dimensions. Anisotropic expansion means different expansion in different dimensions. So as I can substitute the value, alpha x is 13 into 10 raised to minus 7. Alpha y and z is same. So it's like 2 times 231 into 10 raised to minus 7. We get it as 13 plus 462 common 10 raised to minus 7. And so the final answer is 475 into 10 raised to minus 7 per degree Celsius.